Hello friends, welcome back to the revision series from Science and Technology. Hope your preparation is going very well and you're revising all the things which you have read in the last 1.5 years. So in this revision series, we are covering all the current affairs from Science and Technology. Hope aap sabhi pehle 5 lectures ko dekha. This is part 6 of the lecture. So yahan hum kya kar rahe hain? Hum cover kar rahe hain defense and space technology se current affairs. So what are the things that we are covering for today? We are going to cover INS Vikramaditya. उसके बाद हम देखते हैं INS Nilgiri के बारे में और हम देखते हैं उसके बाद 30-meter telescope. What is 30-meter telescope? What is the contribution of India for the 30-meter telescope? After that, हम देखते हैं Air Independent Propulsion System के बारे में. After that, we will talk about the planet with highest number of moons. After that, we will see what is Gemini device, what is ISKCON mission, what is BrahMos missile. After that, we will talk about the geo tail and finally we will end with meteor showers and why it was in news. चलिए शुरू करते हैं. First, INS Vikramaditya. INS Vikramaditya is India's only aircraft carrier. So India has currently only one aircraft carrier and this is INS Vikramaditya. It is in service from 2013. We imported INS Vikramaditya from Russia. We have taken a ship and modified according to our own needs. It is a Kiev class aircraft carrier from Russia. Okay, so INS Vikramaditya is India's only aircraft carrier. Next one, INS Nilgiri. INS Nilgiri is a new stealth frigate. It is a stealth frigate. What is stealth frigate? Frigate is something nothing but a ship. Stealth frigate is that ship which cannot be detected by radars. So stealth technology is that technology which will not allow radars to detect that object. So what is, why that happens? Because for a radar to detect an object, it has to reflect the waves. With extraordinary aerodynamic designs and all, the extraordinary designs, we are making sure that the radars are not able to capture, you know, the object. The radars are not able to detect that object. So that is the stealth technology. So we are improving in this. So this new stealth frigate of India, INS Nilgiri, is from Project 17A. Project 17A is continuation of Project 17. Project 17, wherein which we have produced Shivalik class stealth frigates under Project 17 at Mazagon Dock Limited, MDL, Goa. So this Project 17A is continuation of Project 17. So this is INS Nilgiri. It is a new stealth frigate of Indian Navy. Next one, 30-meter telescope. 30-meter telescope is a large telescope which, you know, few countries are combining, are building together. This large telescope is built by few countries together. These countries are Canada, China, India, Japan and USA. So these 5 countries are combinedly building this, are funding and building this 30-meter telescope at Hawaii. So Hawaii Islands are, you know, the island of Hawaii is a dormant volcano. So there, here you can see the planned location is Moana Key on the island of Hawaii in US state of Hawaii. So Hawaii belongs to US. So there we are building this, 30-meter telescope. So India is contributing about 70%, you know, 70% of Indian contribution is in form of hardware and software to that telescope. So the India is contributing hugely in form of hardware and software. So this 30-meter telescope is an astronomical observatory with an extremely large telescope. It's an extremely large astronomical telescope whose planned location is Hawaii. So 5 countries are involved: Canada, China, India, Japan and USA. Okay. So this 30-meter telescope is designed for near ultraviolet to mid-infrared observations, featuring adaptive optics to assist in correcting image blur. So this is a very advanced telescope which 5 countries are combinedly building. So how this will help India? This will help India in various ways. We are going to get new, you know, get new technologies which other countries are using to build various telescopes and all. This will be immensely helpful for our research and development. Okay, so that is why India will try to involve, not in India, most of the countries will try to involve in these global collaboration projects. Next one. Next one is about the air independent propulsion. This air independent propulsion is nothing but using an engine without air. So there are various, you know, there are various things. There are various engines where without using air, if we can use that engine, it will become very efficient. That vehicle will become very efficient. One is submarine and two is the aircraft. Okay, two is the aircraft. So this DRDO, you know, it has tested an indigenously built air propulsion system, air independent propulsion system. That means a submarine, when it is going under the sea, it needs air for the combustion. So when it is out of air, it used to come up. But if we use this air independent propulsion, that means the submarine is not going to utilize outside air for propulsion, for the combustion of the, you know, fuel, then the submarine can stay in the water for a long time. That is the advantage of the air independent propulsion. So DRDO is a step closer to boosting endurance of submarine with the indigenously built air independent propulsion system. It has successfully tested the operation of indigenously based prototype. So it is indigenously built. This air independent propulsion, it is any technology which allows a non-nuclear submarine to operate without the need of access to atmospheric oxygen. So this is non-nuclear. So if we take a nuclear submarine, the nuclear submarines don't require oxygen at all, oxygen or any gas, because they use the nuclear fuel. But if you look at the diesel electric, so diesel engines, these diesel engines need air, or in fact oxygen to be specific, for the combustion of fuel. So these diesel engines, for the air, what they used to do is they used to come up after a certain amount of time when the air is, when they are out of air, they used to come up, they take the air, and again they will go inside the deep inside the water. So let's say this is submarine. So when it is out of air, it used to come up, it will take the air, and again it will go down. This used to happen. Okay. So now with the introduction of such a technology, this will be very helpful, because the submarine can stay in water for a long time. So it can remain stealth for longer. That is about the air independent propulsion system, and DRDO has carried a prototype test. Next one, Saturn is the planet with highest number of moons. Till now, the planet with highest number of moons is Jupiter. But recently, we have discovered about 20 new moons in Saturn. So with this discovery, the number of moons in Saturn has reached 82. Okay. So with this, Saturn has become the planet with highest number of moons. This was announced by the International Astronomical Union. So International Astronomical Union is that union which will, you know, name the celestial bodies, and also which will, you know, give various definitions related to the space. So this has found, after founding the two new moons, the number of moons of Saturn is 82, and it has become the planet with highest number of moons. Next one, Gemini device. Gemini is Gagan enabled marine instrument for navigation and information device. Gemini device. It is a device used for seamless and effective dissemination of emergency information. So it's basically a satellite based, you know, information dissemination system. So using satellite, it will help in exchange of information. So it has various potentials, because normally when, you know, the fishermen of anyone goes inside the sea, they will not have access to the information. So with the bringing of these devices, they can directly use the satellite technology, and they can, you know, pass information to these fishermen and the people who are going into the sea. So this Gemini device, it is used for seamless and effective dissemination of emergency information, communication on disaster warning, potential fishing zones, and ocean state forecast to the fishermen. Generally, if a fisherman go into the sea, he will stay in the sea for 10 to 15 days. So they'll stay in the, you know, sea for such a long time. So when they're staying in sea for such a long time, anything can happen, because cyclone can develop in few days. But when they're in the sea, they don't know the information about the cyclones and all. So this will be very dangerous for them. So for that only, we have launched this Gemini device. It will help to provide information related to disaster warnings when fishermen move away from the coast, up to, that is 10 to 12 kilometers beyond the coast. If they go, they will get the information. Gemini device receives and transfers the data from the Gagan satellite. Gagan is a satellite that India has, through Bluetooth communication. So Bluetooth is used for this type of communication. It is developed by Indian National Center for Ocean Information Services and Airport Authority of India. They have commonly developed this Gemini device. Next one, Icon mission. Icon mission belongs to NASA. So NASA has developed this Icon mission. So NASA has launched a satellite Icon to detect the dynamic zones of Earth's ionosphere. We know Earth has different layers in the atmosphere: troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and the ionosphere. These are the layers that we have, you know, from ground to space. So this NASA has launched this satellite, you know, to study the ionosphere. Satellite Ionosphere Connection Explorer, Icon. Icon means the Satellite Ionosphere Connection Explorer, was launched from an aircraft over Atlantic Sea near the Florida coast. The Earth's ionosphere includes various layers of the uppermost atmosphere, where free electrons flow freely. This mission is operated by University of California. So that layer, why it is called ionosphere, is it has a lot of ions which will allow the passage of various, you know, communication, which will help in the communication devices. So which will help the aid the communication devices in the passage of various waves. Okay. So this is about the ICON mission. Next, the BrahMos missile. The BrahMos missile will be in use on most days. So for various reasons, you know, when like an enemy country did, you know, threatens India, we will say that we have BrahMos. India is also trying to, you know, sell BrahMos to countries like Vietnam and all. So that's why having information related to BrahMos is very important. The BrahMos is a supersonic cruise missile, which travels almost at Mach 2.8 speed. That is 2.8 times the speed of sound. It has a range of about 290 kilometers. Currently, work for BrahMos 2 is in progress, where the speeds are where the range is going to be above 400 kilometers, and the speed is going to be 4 to 5 Mach. So it is named after, you know, Brahmaputra River of India and Moskva of Russia. So it's called BrahMos. The range of BrahMos can be extended to 400 kilometers as certain technical restrictions were removed after India joined the MTCR regime. So India joined the MTCR in 2016. After that, India now can get the technology where a missile can be sent beyond 400 kilometers. Next one, Geotail. Geotail was in news. So what is this Geotail? Geotail is something, you know, it is a narrow passage. So this narrow passage is called Geotail, where we can get the best observation. Okay, so just a minute. Here you can see this Geotail can get the best observation. So Chandrayaan 2, which was launched last year by India, so it has detected signatures of elements in the moon's soil and had detected the charged particles. So Geotail is the place where we can, you know, observe clearly. And the Chandrayaan 2 has observed various charged particles during its flight. So the region exists as a result of the interaction between sun and the earth. So it can exist. So Geotail is that passage where observation is very clear, where we can observe very clearly. Next one, meteor shower. So meteor shower was in use last year for various reasons. There are a lot of meteor showers that we witness every year. Meteor showers are those showers, or you can say are that phenomena where several meteors enter into the earth atmosphere and burn on their way. So meteor showers are witnessed when earth passes through a trail of debris left by comet or an asteroid. When a meteor reaches the earth, it is called meteorite. So when a body from the space enters into the earth atmosphere, it is called meteor. If that meteor is not burned completely and if it reaches the earth, it is called meteorite. So when large number of small particles come into the earth atmosphere, they burn and it appears to us like a shower. So they are called meteor showers. So when the meteor showers are coming, there will be a lot of particles which are not burned completely and they will fall on the earth. Okay, so then they are called meteorites. Okay, so now let's revise what we have studied so far. First, we have seen what is INS Vikramaditya, which is nothing but India's only aircraft carrier. Next, INS Nilgiri is a stealth frigate. Is under Project 17A. Stealth frigate under Project 17A. Project 17 is Shivalik class frigates. 30-meter telescope is being built by 5 countries: China, India, Canada, USA, and Japan at Hawaii. Okay, at Hawaii is a Hawaii is an state of USA. Okay, so these 5 countries are planning to build a 30-meter telescope, which is a large telescope, in fact. And next is about the air independent propulsion, where DRDO has carried a successful test of the indigenously developed air independent propulsion system. This air independent propulsion system can be used in submarines. Next is the planet with highest number of moons. The planet with highest number of moons is currently Saturn. Earlier it used to be Jupiter. After discovering 20 moons of Saturn, it has become the planet with largest number of moons. Next is Gemini device. It is the device which is used to transmit information to fishermen and all who go into the sea of about 10 to 12 kilometers. If they go deep into the sea, they will be getting information using this device. This device uses information from Gagan satellite. Next is the ICON mission. ICON is the mission of NASA. It used to study the ionosphere. Next is BrahMos missile. BrahMos missile is the missile jointly developed by India and Russia. The range of BrahMos is 290 kilometers. Next is the geotail. Geotail is that narrow passage wherein which observations can be made clearly on the moon. Next is the meteor shower. The meteor shower is nothing but the group of meteors that enter into the Earth atmosphere and burn, and we see them as a burning shower. So it is called meteor shower. Okay. So that's it friends in this lecture. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.